right, well, I'm back at it here again, once again, to talk about Ghost Recon Wildlands and why I still enjoy it, why I still play it, and it's just basically to continue off that kind of unscripted discussion I just put out the other day. I kind of wanted to continue on with that because there's still a few things on my mind that I did want to talk about. Anytime I do these discussions, especially the unscripted ones, where I'm not necessarily going into these kind of videos like knowing exactly what's going to come out of my mouth, like even today. So yeah, when I go back and I listen back and I'm uploading the other video, I realize, you know, there's a few things in there you forgot to mention, a few things that slipped my mind in the moment, so I'm here to clarify that, add them in, and continue to talk, all right? So here we are. For Ghost Recon Wildlands, guys, one of the main things I forgot to point out in my previous video is the fact that each area, each base that you come across feels so unique. There's more variation in Wildlands than there was in Breakpoint, and no, I'm not going to sit here and just shit on Breakpoint and compare the two games, because I don't want to do that. They're both very unique in their own way. They're both very similar, but in a sense, they're very different, all right? Again, Breakpoint has a lot of the things that Wildlands didn't have, like prone camo, and again, I mentioned this the last one, cutting fences and little things like that. Little things where, you know, you're playing Wildlands, and again, you're wishing, like, oh, I wish I can cut this fence, but I guess I gotta blow it up with a grenade and possibly give away my position in order to get through. So yeah, there's things like that, and that's where I think if we had features like that into Wildlands, along with the team play from the original Ghost Recon, then Wildlands would be the number one Ghost Recon game. So yeah, just to go back on it, the environments and the areas that you can explore, all the different kind of bases and camps and enemy positions, all the areas that you get to fight in, that you get to set up these kind of tactical takedowns with your squad when you want to mark targets. Like, Wildlands just had a great area selection, I'd say, where it's just a good spread of enemies. And honestly, guys, when it comes to engagements and firefights in Wildlands, I've noticed that you could actually hold still. And I think I mentioned this in what we need in the next Ghost Recon video, the one where I did the catawampus thing and all the comedy and all that, those cuts and funny bits and shit. I mentioned it there. So in Wildlands, you can have better engagements, better firefights, all right? And that's the thing I like more about Wildlands, is that when I want to go loud, even on tier one or on the hardest difficulty, I can get into cover and I can engage targets at a distance and they will plant themselves, all right? It's not as good as Gra 2 or Gra 1, where the enemies will actively seek out cover properly and actually play smart and even sometimes flank you. And that's also why I preach so heavily about Gra 1 and Gra 2 enemies, especially the co-op when I did that co-op video, because the enemies are so fun to engage in that game, and they're wild, they're crazy, they hide in the bushes and they drop you like you're nothing. But in Wildlands, we have those damn Sicarios that on tier one, especially when you're playing ghost mode and stuff, or not ghost mode, sorry, on tier one, where they can one shot you with their little Mac 10s from like 2 miles away. It's ridiculous. So it gets a little intense when you're playing tier one, especially. So be aware of that, especially on ghost mode. It can lead to you guys just losing profiles that you've spent 100 hours on. It's unfortunate, but that's how it is, man. And that's why Wildlands is a little unforgiving. But in those moments when you're trying to actually complete that kind of thing and you're trying to do that, that's where it gets real hard, and that's where you really need to lean in on those tactics, on the ability to stay in cover and engage targets smartly and make sure you land those shots, all right? And that's where Wildlands again shines for me, because in Breakpoint I noticed that even on the hardest difficulty, I'm not getting that difficulty. I know that people mentioned Spartan mod, which unfortunately I can't try, but I've read a little bit into that. I haven't looked in too much, so I don't want to shoot down the Spartan mod. I've also recommended it to people before in my videos, because I think you guys should try it. Of course, if it's going to make Breakpoint harder, go for it. But that's, again, guys, just as base games is what the games are naturally, Wildlands is more intense for me. It's a lot more harder, I'd say, all right? Because the enemies, again, they're a lot more difficult. They're a lot more tactful. Maybe not so much tactful, but they're a lot more, I guess, deadly in how they fire at you and in the way that they hold still and that they're just relentless. It's an onslaught is what it feels like in Wildlands. Whereas in Breakpoint, it's kind of like, yo, you come across a pocket of enemies, you deal with them, and that's it. It gets all quiet, it hushes down, and then you're in this kind of open space that doesn't have too much like things to do next. You got to kind of travel a while just to reach the next enemy. Whereas in Wildlands, I feel like every 10 seconds I'm coming across something that I could tackle. I'm coming across something that I can do. Anywhere I drive, there's enemy patrols constantly. And in Breakpoint, there's specific spots where enemies will spawn on roads. Like, I put out a video the other day doing the future soldier outfits, and there was a spot there where I cut in a couple footage clips of me taking out some vehicles, right? And it's because in those areas, vehicles are known to pass, and that's where you will get to engage targets in vehicles a lot more in Breakpoint in certain areas. But in Wildlands, it's everywhere. There's vehicles everywhere, all right? In Wildlands, there's just constant things for you to do and tackle. And again, the areas, those play spaces that you're in, they literally literally cover every single type of play space in GR history, every type of biome that you want to engage in and get in some good engagements in. Wildlands has that. It's a little bit low on snow environments. And again, that's where Breakpoint really kind of filled that void. Again, another case of Breakpoint just doing things, adding more things that Wildlands didn't have and kind of learning from it. Ubisoft definitely learned a few things from Wildlands going into Breakpoint. Sure, they dropped a lot of good stuff, and sure, they may have slipped up a little bit more on Breakpoint, but they definitely did answer that. We got a lot more snow. So anyways, guys, back to the point here. So Wildlands, again, has a lot of biomes for you to tackle, and every area in Wildlands feels like it's connected to the original Ghost Recon games. If I want to fight in, like, a construction site with cranes or an oil rig, like, you can do that in Wildlands. You want some lush jungles, you can do that in Wildlands. You want open plains, farm fields, like GR1, for example. Wildlands has that. Sure, Breakpoint has that too, but, I mean, Wildlands has just, again, more detail, more grit, more earth-like feeling to it. It feels more real. It feels not so, it's not as clean. Again, I'm going to say that again. Breakpoint's too clean compared to Wildlands. Wildlands has that grit, that kind of dark tones. You can really get that feeling that you're in like a film, almost like a war movie. There's just so many fucking great little details in Wildlands that Breakpoint unfortunately just couldn't live up to. Like, you look at a blank wall, for example, in Wildlands, you're going to see graffiti, you're going to see grit, you're going to see wear and tear, you're going to see that, hey, this thing has been put through battles, war, whatever it is. It's got detail. You know, there's graffiti on the streets, there's lights, there's marketplaces with civilians, there's just all this great stuff. There's patrols walking through those towns, there's sicarios filled up in buildings. There's a lot more buildings for you to tackle in Wildlands. Actual, like, towns, things like that. Sure, there's a limited amount of them. Sure, it's a lot of copy and paste buildings. And sure, there's no doors on all those buildings because you can't even break through them and stuff, except for the ones where you got to do those little radio things, or you got to go in, clear out the bunker, blow up the door, clear out the targets, and quickly hack the laptop within a certain time frame. Sure, there's that in Wildlands, but again, the doors in Wildlands, a lot of the buildings are just open. They've never been closed, so you can't really do that breach and clear stuff by blowing open doors and stuff in Wildlands. So again, a lot of the things that Wildlands lacks, Breakpoint kind of brought up, because Breakpoint actually has doors that open. Sure, you can't blow those fuckers open either, but at least there's some of that in Breakpoint, right? But anyways, guys, back to Wildlands. Why do I still love it? Why do I still play it? Again, we've spoken about it already. I do love the engagements. I love that I can sit still and plant myself with my squad and just fucking get into these engagements, these firefights, especially in towns. And then sometimes reinforcements will come in, and it just opens up the door to even more just bonkers play sessions, man. Really fun, engaging, exciting, like, firefights for you to tackle and immerse yourself in and play in. And that's what Wildlands offers. Sometimes you're walking through a town, all of a sudden you get into a gunfight on a road and there's cars parked and you start fucking, bullets are popping off, civilians are running away, and then all of a sudden more units come in, reinforcements, maybe even UNIDAD, and then you have UNIDAD and cartel, and it's just this big grand thing, and then you want to call in some rebel support, and then you have this nice little fucking battle happening in a small town. And that's where Wildlands shines, guys, all right? Because as much as the ghosts are these kind of crouch walking stealth ghosts, they're also these loud motherfuckers who like to show that they're there and that they're not joking around, because the ghosts are scary. And that's why it's so fun to play as the ghosts. That's why Ghost Recon draws a lot of us to it, because it's the ghost. There's this mysteriousness to it. And that's where, again, Wildlands allows you to really just play up that mysteriousness, because especially at nighttime when you're going through these towns and you're playing as your ghosts and you just feel like you're so immersed. And Wildlands, just, it has those towns for you to immerse in, especially at night, whereas Breakpoint doesn't. You got, like, small little areas, maybe a town center, and there's maybe a few workers or something, but there's none of that, like, life, there's none of that world building, there's none of that sense of being, like, I'm being placed in this town, in this country, whereas Wildlands does satisfy that. Sure, we don't have streets and, like, city-like play spaces in Wildlands as much as we do in Grawl 1 and Grawl 2, and that's where I hope, again, we see some more urban areas with bigger buildings, more city-like streets. That way we can get into those kind of gunfights like Ghost Recon 2 had. There's a lot of that kind of, like, city, like, torn down cities that you can fight in and stuff. So again, guys, Wildlands is what it's why I still play Wildlands. All this fun stuff that it offers and all this great tactical freedom that you have. I really did enjoy just the co-op and how it's just how it's just set up. It's just a party mode. You go in, you do your thing. Sure, Breakpoint has the same. And when I said earlier in my last video, tell me one game that's better co-op than Wildlands. Tell me. Like you can't change my mind, right? Well, I was saying that in regards to Wildlands and in regards to modern day Ghost Recon. Sure, Graw 1 and 2, they're really high up there in terms of co-op and how fun they are. But I'm mostly referring to Wildlands and Breakpoint. I'd say they have some really good co-op, man. And sure, I said Wildlands is the best co-op, but Breakpoint also has amazing co-op too. I think they're both fun. And again, Wildlands and Breakpoint, because they're developed to be co-op games, they're not developed to be classic Ghost Recon where it's you, the player, fighting with your squad and using squad controls and team and tactical and all that stuff. Wildlands and Breakpoint wants you to do it with real people. They want you to play with friends. And that's why I guess the focus was on gear and loot and buying and microtransactions and skins and guns and all these things, because they want you and your friends to kind of compare each other. They want you and your friends to dress up and be like, yo, look what I'm wearing. Oh, what are you wearing? Oh, sick. That's a cool fit. What do you got on, man? Like, they wanted to kind of introduce that, and because they spend so much time on that, a lot of the real stuff loses. It misses out on being in the game. Again, that's why we don't have proper squad commands. And the squad commands that we do have, like for example in Breakpoint, they're so bad. It's so bad. You tell a squad to move here, they'll go there, but then they'll just start wandering off into different directions. You tell them to hold, they'll hold for like a split second, and they'll start running around in circles in the area. They don't do what you're telling them to do. In Wildlands, they act a little bit better. They act just a little bit better, but again, it's still lacking, all right? So again, Wildlands, Breakpoint, love-hate relationship. Clearly, I have a love-hate relationship with them. I'm still covering them. I'm still playing them, and it's for a reason. It's because I enjoy them, all right? They're fun, but Wildlands just did something a little bit more special to me. It really created an atmosphere. It really created a great playground for you and just so many different provinces and environments for you to just like work in. And again, so much tactical opportunity in Wildlands. So many more areas that are more populated with things, even objects for you to take cover in geometry and in civilian. And just everything that you can do in Wildlands was just a little bit better, all right? Minus those few features that Breakpoint brought that we wish Wildlands had. So yeah, the areas you fight in Wildlands are a lot more established. They're a lot more, well-developed. A lot more effort and thought was put into how they're going to place each object in each area. Like, for example, anytime you look at me playing Wildlands, you just look at the areas that I'm fighting in. Each area just felt like it's just, everything's just so perfectly mapped out. Like, each map area is just so fun to play in. There's different levels to it. It just felt more well-rounded in terms of the play space you're offered in Wildlands, whereas in Breakpoint, again, it was lacking a little bit for me. And yet, I still can be very immersed in Breakpoint, don't get me wrong, but again, it just felt more copy and paste, like a lot of the same bunkers, a lot of the same buildings being reused in different bases. And one of the main things, guys, is that in Breakpoint, a lot of the bases, a lot of the enemy camps and stuff, they're a lot more spread apart. There's a lot more dead space in Breakpoint, whereas in Wildlands, again, a lot of things are a lot more close in proximity. And anytime you get into a helicopter and you fly all the way up real super high above the clouds almost, and you look down, you can see all the lights from the different cities, especially at night. And you can see that Wildlands just has way more pockets, way more areas, way more great areas for you to jump in and fucking hell jump into, because there's so much more. They're not as far between. All the areas, all the little towns, the little parts of each province, they're all perfectly mapped out in a great way, and they're not that far apart from each other. So in Breakpoint, again, you look at an area, you fly right up to the clouds, and you look down, and you see how far between things are. There might be a big-ass mountain that cuts in the way of the two camps that you want to hit up. And that's the thing, when it comes to Breakpoint, it looks like there was less tactfulness by the developers in terms of how they staged those areas and how they put them together. Because again, a lot of walking, a lot of dead areas, a lot of open areas that just felt so dead. And sure, they added some patrols here and there, and you can be walking for Breakpoint and then say like in 30 seconds you'll come across like say four wolves walking, but that's great and all, but it's not enough. Whereas in Wildlands, you keep walking 30 seconds and all of a sudden you're at this little kind of like garage dump area, and there's just like targets in there, and it's like you can see there's like sniper towers, positions, enemies here and there, and it just felt a lot more filled with life and a lot more filled with options for you to have your tactical creativity freedom and your tactical creative mind run wild. You can do these different things. Like, I put a video up the other day where we did that nice clean grab on that target. I'll probably put the video up in here anyway. anyways, and then I'll direct you to go click on it after this video is done and check it out for real with real volume and all that. But yeah, you can set these things up. You can have an airstrike go this way. You can have your rebel support attack that, and then you can go directly in and flashbang dudes and take them down. And it's that tactical kind of freedom that you have, and it's the ability to do those things that unfortunately you can't do playing solo. You got to do it in co-op, and that's where, again, Wildlands and Breakpoint were designed to be co-op games, and that's why they shine more in that space, and that's why people critique them so much. Because when you play alone and you really kind of try to get in there with your squad, with your team, and you try to play it like you do the older Ghost Recon games, you're gonna be upset. You're gonna get into positions where you're like, what the fuck is this crap? Because they didn't put the effort into those mechanics. They forgot about them, all right? And that's why I push for what I push for. If the next Ghost Recon game is gonna be open world, because we already know it's Ubisoft and that's all they do is open world now, which it will be open world, I'm telling you now. They will not do the sandbox, different countries thing that I'm pushing for. They will never do that because it's Ubisoft. They will give us an open world. And when they give us an open world, they better look at Wildlands. They better look at the successes of Wildlands and what draws players to Wildlands so much to this day that we still talk about it. The reason why you see so many comments saying, just give us a Wildlands 2, as much as I don't agree with that, there's a reason why people keep saying it. Because Wildlands was special. There's something about it that just makes it special. But what is that something? And I think I've maybe captured it in these discussions, but that something to me is just how detailed it is, how each area was well thought out, how each area feels so immersive. Again, guys, that's what does it for me in Wildlands. The fact that I can load in and go into any spot and immediately feel like I'm playing an individual game. I can be in one province that's heavily, you know, full of trees and forests, and I could be rummaging through that and kind of doing my thing and having a good time. But then I can also go to more of a desert area or an open plain area, and you can feel like you're in a different game, guys. And that's where, again, Wildlands really does hold a special place in my heart and just me as a gamer, man. I've been playing this game for years, and I'll continue to play it for who knows how long, until I guess there's another GR game. I'm gonna still keep cranking Wildlands because I love it. I love it to death. It's fun. It's there's a reason why people still play games like Arma. It's because you have this, you have these options. You have all this great stuff that you can just play with. You can do what you want. Sure, there's not too much mod support on Wildlands on behalf of Ubisoft, so you're not going to get that same kind of level that Arma gives you, but at least in Wildlands, it's more easy to jump into. A lot of players can easily hop in and without too much of a learning curve, and you can kind of get it. You can kind of wrap your head around it and realize that this is really a playground to do whatever you want. You want to play tactically like the original games. You want to kind of funnel that style of play into your playing like I do personally. That's how I do it. Then you can do that. That's why I try and kind of play the Wildlands and Breakpoint kind of like I'm playing Grawl 1 or 2, because it's that third person kind of feel. You're using cover, you're moving your squad up cover to cover, and I guess that's where Breakpoint and Wildlands still, they lack in that regard, but at least they allow you to do that. But yeah, sure, in Breakpoint you tell a squad to go there, they start wandering all over the place, but at least in Wildlands I feel like they're a little bit more secure. You tell them to do something, they do it, and they actually stay put. It feels more like that in Wildlands, and that's again another reason why I do love Wildlands, man. So there's a lot of reasons why I love Wildlands, there's a lot of reasons why I critique it, but there's a reason why I'm still talking about it, there's a reason why we all still play it, and it's because it's just plain old fun, man. It's a plain old fun game. You want to just shit disturb with your buddies and act like fucking idiots, you can do that. You can play the game like a stupid action-packed shooter and just have a good time. There's nothing wrong with that. We all do it. We all have our fun. And then you can go and you can play it nice and tactical. You can get nice and low and just get real into it and have a good time. And that's where Wildlands again shines, all right? And again, you have all these towns, all these areas, all well mapped out, perfect plots of cover in each thing, and never gets dry, it never gets boring. And that's why I'm so passionate about Wildlands, all right? And that's why, again, I still play it. So again, I'm gonna ask you guys the same thing. Why do you still play Wildlands? Or why do you dislike Wildlands? What was it that pissed you off about Wildlands? Or maybe you're like me, where you were upset with Wildlands at one point, but then you really started to appreciate it and love it more once you really realized what it was, and you kind of wrapped your head around it and kind of figured, you know what? You can still have fun with it. You can still get right in there and have a good time. So tell me, where do you stand on the Wildlands topic? Because I know this is a game that split the player base. Actually, I think Future Soldier was the game that split the Ghost Recon player base. And I'd say they brought it back into a more GR space with Wildlands and Breakpoint. I think even though it's open world again, and a lot of the open world stuff is a little dead and open and stupid, especially in Breakpoint, at least these games felt a little bit more like Ghost Recon should be, as opposed to like Future Soldier, where it was just a run and gun linear game, and it lacked that kind of sandbox style. Whereas like in Future Soldier, you're playing a mission and you come across five targets, right? And those five targets will always be in those same spots because it's just a linear mission. That's all it is. It was an experience. It was a really well done experience. It almost felt like a Ghost Recon playable movie is what Future Soldier felt like to me. And it was actually really fun multiplayer too. I did play that as well. I know a lot of you guys love the Future Soldier multiplayer, but yeah, man. So anyways, guys, I love Wildlands still. I'm still going to play it, still going to talk about it, because it's a game that just really does appeal to me. It answers a lot of the stuff I need. When I want a Ghost Recon experience, I know that I can safely load into Wildlands and I can get that fun. I won't ever load into Wildlands and then end my session feeling like, oh, what the fuck did I just do? Whereas in Breakpoint, sometimes I'll play and I end my session, I'm like, fuck, man, that was so annoying. So anyways, guys, that's why I still love Wildlands. That's why I still love to play it and still talk about it. And please share your thoughts, guys. I know I fucking talked way too much today, but I think it's good to get some discussions going again, because I used to do discussions all the time, and I really want to get back into that and do a lot more of these. So if you guys like these kind of videos where I'm just spewing shit out of my mouth, you let me know, man. I know not all you guys like to hear someone else talk. Sometimes it's aggravating. You're hearing someone else share their opinions for 20 minutes that don't necessarily align with yours, and you wish you can just jump through the screen and just choke me out and be like, no, you fucker, that's not right. But hey, man, we all have our opinions, all right? So feel free to hate me all you want, but at least drop a comment and chat with us, because I think it's fun to talk about the games that we all enjoy playing. Sure, we like to do our play sessions and do all that stuff, but hey, sometimes we want to get together and just fucking have a chat, all right? And that's what I like to do sometimes. So let me know if you enjoy these types of videos. I'll try and keep them up a lot more like I used to. And yeah, man, let's have a chat, guys. Drop some comments and let's see what you have to say, all right? Because we know I talk way too fucking much, man. Anyways, guys, as always, thank you for watching and take it easy.